out why, you know, I act the way I do, things that I see other people do. So I'm gonna talk about the flesh today, you know, about what makes us do things, what makes us look back and say things like, wow, why do people commit these negative things, or why do we feel good? You know, our flesh is our enemy, I believe. And I believe the blood is our only weapon. The blood of Jesus. So I wrote a little something out there. And I look back and I say to him, I used to do that back in the day when I was like 5, and I still do it when I'm 29. You know?
I know.
So I wrote a little something, I say, I know what my problem is. I got baby sins. Baby problems. And I need to grow up. And my only way of growing up is to attend to the Lord's word. I'm gonna read a little something. Just bear with me. I'm gonna cut through a little bit. I don't wanna waste too much time. I say, born in sin, but blessed within, settled with him. The first time we took our first wind, we were hitting our skin to be tested with sin. Baby sins are spirits that came into our lives to keep us from our God, Lord Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus is our only weapon that we were gifted with. These sins still are within us to this day. We were made, be with me on this, we were made to imperfect the perfect. To seek God through faith and prayer. The only way we can seek God is faith and prayer. Things that we see and things that we feel are not all what is believable. These sins are not like the, you know, you think of, you know, when you see today on the news, you see murderers, you see killers, or they must have been born like that, or why, what happened to them. These are things that come to us. We don't know what's in our skin to make us do certain things. You know? Everybody following me?
Yeah.
All right. You ever feel anger and you look at somebody and you say, you know, why are they acting like that? You know, what are they doing? Or why do I feel that way? Why is my skin burning? I can't stand this person. This is a baby sin that I'm talking about. You may not understand what it is and when it hit you, when it got on you, because you were born with it, born in sin. That's the baby sin, pride. Follow me on this real quick. The baby sin, pride for attention. We did that. You know, the cell phone was a pretty bad idea. We're out of the zone. I'm going to do it another time. Okay. The baby can cry for attention because it inflicts pain to the flesh. You wonder why we cry when we're born. And they say, oh, well, your baby's alive. That's you when baby's alive. To me, it's when you're born, when God made you, you were perfect from the beginning of the baby, pushing his mother's womb. You were protected. Nothing hit you. No sin, no negativity, anything. You weren't put under a certain degree of person. You understand? But that second that you were born, when you came into the world and this atmosphere, you were hit with sin. You were hit with things that you couldn't understand. That's why you cried. Because the flesh is being attacked. The sin cries for attention, claws on our flesh, and teas on our faith. Now everybody knows what a baby tea is. It's war. Terrible too. Because what it does is it wants you to try to, like a baby, go into the ignorant steps or something like that. You say, hey, don't do that. You're going to get hurt, but then at that time you need a baby crying. So they get you to experience that. So your flesh experiences a lot of different things. You just have to somewhat understand it. But as you grow, you have to grow. And the only way to grow is in the Lord. That's it. So it brought me to a scripture. I'm just skipping around. It's a little long. But it brought me to Proverbs. Thanks to my mother, she brought me a prayer card that I look at every morning. And I walk out to do my day. I just look. I don't even try to pinpoint it, but I just look. And it brought me to Proverbs when I was thinking about, you know, why I consume so much things that try to get me to do wrongful things, or try to get to my mind, or try to make me feel a certain way. So Proverbs 4:22. For they are life unto those that find them, and health to all their flesh. Now, to me, I just look at it like I've been saying. The only way I've been getting rid of my own personal, fleshly problems is to read. We wonder why when we come to church and that, you know, somebody's speaking or the minister's speaking, and everybody says, oh, it's hot in church, and you get fanned. It's not just hot in church. That's the sin being from the body, I believe. It's coming up off you, getting that word. It doesn't want you to hear. It wants you to leave. It doesn't want you to come to church. It likes to stay by you. Babies like to try to stay in one spot, and well, they move around a lot, but they want your attention only. They don't. These things don't want the attention that you give it to the Lord. They don't want it. So as you get it, it brings you into this understanding where, like, you know, I got to do something for myself. Once you get that time when you get to say, I need better, I want better, you have to grow. And I know I'm repeating myself, so let me get to the end of this, because I'm still worried about time. Okay, I'm going to do this part. I personally had a baby in college, but I wiped my own butt, changed my own diaper, washed my own back, while cleaning my own property. God needs us to grow and share the word like we did in the 3K. Everybody knows the 3K is where we are right here. We have to grow in the word gradually to get that accomplishment, to be at his level. I'm looking for words, but being a heavy Christian, that's the best glory I can even think of, you know, is to finally get a grasp of yourself, which you never will, because you are imperfect in this imperfect world. But the only way to be with the Lord is to see Jesus and follow his head. I want to throw one more thing in there. What I'm reading off right now, and what gets me to everybody that's texting nowadays, right? A lot of children, and I have a lot to say about the youth. We speak and we use too much technology to take away our natural resources of communication as far as texting. So I tell the young one, and they text and they looking down at everything, I said, son, you're reading the wrong text. The real text is in the Bible.
Amen. Amen.